Let's try to understand what is the difference between a CAN load and CAN activate guard, and basically we will try to understand what is the benefit and when I will use the CAN load guard in Angular. I know that it seems very similar, CAN load and CAN activate guard, and that's why it is a little confusing as well, that in what place we need to use the CAN load and CAN activate. So let's try to understand in the detail. Now first you need to use where I will use this guard. So basically guard is used for a navigation purpose, okay? So if you will using a routing, it means if user will try to navigate a particular route or URL or maybe a path, then on that case what should be happen? So here in Angular we are using the router outlet. So after the router outlet, basically we are loading a component. So if I will use a particular route, okay, particular path, then in that case, suppose we want to load a particular component, so at the place of the router outlet, it will get loaded, okay, after the router outlet. Now, this guard is responsible to load a particular component, feature module, or maybe their children's. So this is responsible. We need to allow a loading or not. So we will do these kinds of thing with the help of the guard. So you will generate a guard, means you can create a guard manually, as well as you can generate a guard, skeleton of the guard using the CLI command. So you just need to write ng generate guard and name of this guard, then Angular will ask you, CLI will ask you which guard you want to use. So you can add any of this, which you will get the option of can activate, can deactivate, can activate child, resolve, or can load guard. Okay, you have to select these things. Once you will select, then basic skeleton will get generated. Now, once it will get generated, then all of this necessary or common thing you will get it. Here you can notice that implements can load or can activate, both are I am using into the same guard, so that's why I have implemented. So based on that, this will get generated, okay? The code or maybe skeleton you can say will get generated. Now you need to add your logic. Your logic would be like this. If this can load, okay, what is the can load? First we will need to understand. See, can load is basically, if this will return true, then a particular feature module will get loaded, otherwise it will not get loaded. It means if this will return a false, then feature module will not get loaded. If you will try to navigate a particular path, then you may refer to a feature module, okay? So once you will refer to the feature module, then feature module only get downloaded if the can load will return true. Otherwise, it will not work. It will not downloaded. Okay, that particular feature module. This is only responsible for a feature module need to be downloaded or not. Once it will be downloaded, then this will this is unnecessary, you can say. Okay, now this work is already done. Once it loaded, then there are no use of this can load, because that particular feature module is already loaded. Now what is the can activate? So friends, can activate is only get allowed to load a particular component when suppose once the path will get matched, then you can download or load a particular component. But if you are using the can activate, then if can activate will return true, then you will able to use that particular route. Otherwise, that particular route will not work. It means component, if you are using the component, if user will navigate a particular route and if you want to return a component, then component will be downloaded or maybe used. Otherwise, this will not get utilized. Okay, so once the can activate will return true, then you will able to use a particular route. Otherwise, you will not able to use a particular route. But in case of can load, it's not like this. it is not depend upon the routing. It's depend upon a feature module. Feature module need to be load or not. If this will return true, then feature module will get loaded. Otherwise, it will not get loaded. Once it is loads, then there are no use of this scan load. Now you can see a two path, which is the admin activate or admin load. In case of admin activate, I am using can activate guard, or in case of admin load, I am using the can load guard. Okay, in both the cases, I am trying to load a particular feature module, load children. It means it's a lazy loading. Okay, so I am trying to refer to a particular feature module, which is the admin load module. It means if a user will try to navigate admin activate path, then it will go to the admin module, and whatever instruction is there, which based on that, maybe there are another routing will be there in that particular module, and based on their routing, component will get loaded after the router outlet. Okay, so here first router outlet we will use into the app component, and another one is the dashboard layout component, because I am using the children, so extending it. So there will be a two router outlet. The first router outlet is responsible for this root modules, this routing, and the second one is to load children, to need to be loaded the children at the place of the router outlet. Okay, so and here you can notice that if the path will get matched, then a can activate will only work if that router, this guard will return true. Otherwise, it will not work. Okay, it will not work. In case of the can load, if this guard will return true, then this lazy loading will be happen. It means this feature module will get loaded. Otherwise, this feature module will not get loaded. So let's try to demonstrate it into the here into the browser. So you can notice, if I will try to navigate, see, both of these things, like admin activate and admin load, both of these path I am using this link. So if I will click this, any of this link, then based on that navigation will be happen. So if I will click in admin can activate and admin can load, in both of the cases it is redirecting to the login page. Why it is redirecting? Because I have written this instruction into the guard. Okay, it means this is not working, because it get redirected to the login page. It means the instruction is written like this, that if user will logged in, then we will able to visit. Otherwise, we will not able to visit. It will be redirected to a login page. That's why it's like that. Okay. So I hope that you are not getting confused here. So here you can see, this is the if condition is provided, and that user is login, then it will be returned true. Otherwise, it will redirected to the login page, something like that. Okay. So let's log in first, and then we will try to understand what will happen in both of this routing, in case of the can activate and in case of can load. So I have provided a user, and I'm going to provide here the password as well. So I have logged in. Okay, I have provided a correct username and password, and I have logged in. So since I have logged in, then that's why I'm able to use a admin activate. It means if I will navigate admin activate, in that case this load children is we are provided a path of this modules, which means feature module, and based on the feature module instruction, it is loading whatever component we want to load at the place of the router outlet. That's it. If I will navigate a can load, this one, so you can notice admin load, in case of admin load, can load will return true because user is logged in. So in both of these cases, we will able to access the route, and we will able to load a particular component. Okay. Now, if I will logged out, then what will happen? Let's see. If I will logged out, then you can notice I am in the welcome page. If I will click the can activate, then it is redirecting to login page one again. Why? Because I am logged out. So it means that it is returning false. Can activate guard is returning false. Since it is returning false, that's why I have redirected to the login page. We are not able to access this path. Why? Because can activate returns false. It means we are not able to access this path. It means we are not able to load a children. We will not able to navigate. But in case of can load, if I will click here this can load, then still I am able to use, if still I am able to load a particular component even if I am locked out. So why it is like that? Because of this can load. Because can load is only responsible to load a particular feature module. Once it's loaded, then its job is already done. Okay, because it's already loaded, so there are no much use of this can load. It will work like a, it's not there. Okay, this property is like a not there, because this is only responsible to restrict a feature module to be loaded or not. If it will return true, then it will get loaded, otherwise not. Okay, it means that it is already downloaded into the browser. Since it is already downloaded, then you will able to navigate freely. You can do it because this is only responsible for a feature module. Okay, so I hope you are able to understand what is the can load and what is the difference between can load and can activate guard. If you have any issue, then please comment. Thank you.